my last video was rushed, let's discuss a little about the developments of CS02. During the first release way back in August 2018, I noticed the first video of a private CS02 server and managed to get in contact with the developer, Ochi. So we had discussions on how to salvage the game after Nexon dropped the live support. It was a challenge to obtain the latest client, which is the Korean version, because we weren't expecting those who still kept CS02 installed on their hard drives when the majority had more interest towards CSO. And I too had it uninstalled because, honestly speaking, I was pretty pessimistic about its future revival, if any. Luckily, a friend of mine managed to preserve the Korean version on his PC, and therefore that's how everything started. With the main client, finally Ochi managed to get his hands on the files required for the project. Sometime later, we tested the local hosting server, which wasn't perfect. Everything was on the old school command prompt. Joining maps, adding bots, and running console commands were all done through this black and white interface. While playable, the game was pretty broken. For instance, the inventory didn't work and players could not drop their weapons. It's like the G key didn't work at all. Then we move on to the master server. I could join Ochi's server and vice versa, but only the host could play while the others spectate. The jointing command didn't work and we had to leave it because there was still a long way to go. After noticing the locale, I decided to translate some of the Korean strings into English. Now, this was before the unpackaged CS02 was released to the public, so Ochi only had access to the compiler and tested out the changes on my behalf. And obviously, I wasn't much of an advanced programmer, so I just did what I could by promoting the game. It didn't stir up much interest because mainly there were no clear instructions on starting the client and setting up a master server with Node.js. So things went pretty quiet for a while. Fast forward to late January onwards, I suddenly noticed a major spike in CS02 related posts on Facebook, and that's how it is right now. Finally, with the somewhat improved master server, local ones are popping up here and there. But still, game crashes when you enter wrong details like no username or wrong server IP. While the central server might or might not be in the works, what matters most is that people are able to join hosted lobbies on a limited scale. We'll have to wait until Ochi further improves the netcode and overall the game functionality. Originally, the roadmap planned to cover the database, user inventory, and the login system. Also, another major roadblock is the addition of new user-created contents. We're not talking reskins, but like a totally different weapon, for instance, an AWP that shoots flying kitties. I was informed by Red that Nexon was being a smart cheeky bastard by encrypting the index file, so new contents without the proper decryption tool would not be able to load, and therefore the game crashes whenever a new entry is added. Hopefully we get to bypass the security so we get to see our long-awaited sniper. In the meanwhile, those living in Southeast Asia are free to join the server I hosted, which is located in the video description. And also the translation, which is 485 pages long, but my team is slowly working to complete it. It's very tempting to simply copy and paste with Google Translate, but I plan to make the translations more or less official with the GitHub release, so there's some quality control to consider. Yeah, it'll take some time, but hopefully we'll be done soon enough. If you'd like to install CS02, there's a ton of ways to do so, but I would recommend following the instructions on our website until an official launcher is released, on which I'll update it accordingly.